Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this video class of DIP, we will study image smoothing in frequency domain filtering and its implementation in MATLAB. So up till now, the processing techniques that we have learned in the previous video classes are the spatial domain techniques, which are related to the spatial domain or image plane domain, whereas here we will be studying the image enhancement in the frequency domain. That means we'll be converting the image from the spatial domain to the frequency domain. We'll be applying different transformation, and after the transformation is applied, we will come back to the spatial domain, and hence we will be enhancing our image. So as usual, starting with the name itself. Why? Because everything is there in the name. What is the meaning of smoothing? Smoothing means to smooth out an image and to filter out the rapid discontinuities in the image. So this smoothing is used for removing noise in the image, and we know noise is a high frequency content, and we need to remove that noise by smoothing out the image or by blurring the image. So we have seen the smoothing or averaging filters in the spatial domain in the previous classes. Here we'll be studying in frequency domain, and of course we'll be implementing it in MATLAB. The frequency content of an image refers to the rate at which the gray level change in the image. For example, rapidly changing brightness values correspond to high frequency terms, and slowly changing brightness values correspond to low frequency term for image processing. The Fourier transform, which is used for frequency domain filtering, is a mathematical tool that analyzes a signal, or here for our case images, into its spectral components depending on the wavelength, and for our case of image processing, depending on the frequency content or brightness changes or variations of the image. So let us start. We have learned in the previous video class that the low pass filters or smoothing filters can be further classified into three categories: ideal low pass filters, Butterworth low pass filters, and Gaussian low pass filters. And we have also studied that the basic formula for any kind of filtering is based on convolution integral. So our input image f of xy, convolution of filter mask h of xy, gives us our output image g of xy in the spatial domain. Whereas in the frequency domain, after taking the Fourier transform, f of uv, our input image, into h of uv, our filter mask, will give us our output image g of uv. So the difference over here is that in the spatial domain we have to take the convolution, whereas in the frequency domain we only need to do the multiplication, and of course this can be proved mathematically. Conversely, if we take the inverse Fourier transform, we will return back to our spatial domain. So remember, convolution in the spatial domain becomes multiplication in the frequency domain. So hence, for filtering we use the formula g of uv is equal to f of uv into h of uv. So now our objective is to choose h of uv so that we get a low pass filter. Okay, and in all these different types of low pass filters, it is only h of uv that is changing, that is our filter mask is only changing. So starting with ideal low pass filter, it is given by the formula h of uv is equal to 1 if d of uv is less than or equal to D0 and is equal to 0 otherwise. Now what is D0? D0 is our cutoff frequency for the filter, and D of UV is the Euclidean distance from the center of the image that we will be just understanding. So this ideal low pass filter cuts off all high frequency components of the Fourier transform that has a distance greater than a specified distance D0, which is our cutoff frequency. So for the ideal low pass filter, D0 or cutoff frequency is the specified non-negative distance. And now let us understand what is d of uv. So remember, in our previous video class we centered our Fourier transform using the formula f of xy into -1 raised to x plus y. That means we were multiplying our image by -1 raised to x plus y, where x and y are the coordinates of pixel, right? So this d of uv is the distance from the point uv to the origin of the image for a m cross n image, right? This is m, this is n, and you know from our previous video class that this is the center of our image, that is m by 2 n by 2. So now let us take one particular pixel, say this pixel. So this pixel position will be given by d of uv. And how to find out this position? We have already learned in the video class of neighborhood, adjacency, and connectivity. So this distance is the Euclidean distance that we will be finding out from the center of the image. This is m by 2 n by 2. Then the Euclidean distance is given by under root of u minus m by 2 whole square plus of v minus n by 2 whole square. So I hope now it is clear what is d of uv and what is d0. D0 is this particular location, filter mask. For example, let us say if d0 is equal to 5, then h of uv will be a bright circle of radius 5. So this can be easily understood from this formula. So here the black or shaded value, shaded portion has a value 0 and the white portion has a value 1. So depending on the value of d0, the white circle becomes larger or smaller. So when we multiply f of uv and h of uv, only that part of the spectrum is retained that coincides with the white part of h of uv. Everything else becomes 0 as the shaded part of the h of uv is equal to 0. So this type of filter is known as an ideal filter. Why? Because basically it removes everything beyond d0. But can this ideal filters be implemented practically? No. Why? See, nothing is ideal in this world, not even the filter. So although ideal filters cannot be realized using physical components like resistors, capacitors, they can be definitely implemented on a computer. So this figure is the original image and the other figures are the results of filtering using ideal low pass filters with cutoff frequencies set at radius value of 10. This is for 30. This is for 60. So you can see as you increase the cutoff frequency, the power removed by the filter becomes very less. So when the cutoff frequency is very large, the filtering is very less. And when the cutoff frequency is very low, the blurring is also very, very high. So we have to choose the value accordingly. So more the value of this d0, that means larger will be this circle and will be passing all of the information from the image, and hence this image are very clear, but it is of no use, right? Now you can see that for the ideal low pass filter, there is a sharp transition at the point of d0 from 1 to 0. You can see here, this is 1, it sharply becomes 0. This is 1, it sharply becomes 0. So what is the important point to note for this ideal low pass filter? This has a sharp discontinuity and hence ringing effect is present. Now let us understand what is this ringing effect and how to solve or get rid of this ringing effect. So if this is our input signal, the Fourier transform of this input signal is like this, where the signal breaks down into dominant component at the origin and concentric components about the center, like this. Similarly, if you take the inverse Fourier transform of f of uv, we obtain such a signal. So this is nothing but the dual property of the Fourier transform. So therefore, also for our filter mask h of uv, when we take the inverse Fourier transform, we get two distinct characteristics, a dominant component at the center and the concentric components, which you can see here, 1 by d0, 2 by d0 and so on. So now when we convolve this h of xy with the image, we get the ringing effects, since convolution is nothing but copying h of xy at every location. So this can be shown like this in the image form. So more precisely, we can say that the center component is responsible for the blurring or low pass filtering or smoothing, while the concentric circles, which are responsible due to these components, okay, this circle are responsible for the ringing effects which are present. So conclusion is that there should not be sharp cutoffs. So as long as there are sharp cutoffs, their spatial representations will be sync functions and hence ringing will always be present for ideal low pass filter. Now you may think that if we increase d0, the sync function becomes narrow and hence ringing effects looks more pronounced in the image. So to eliminate this ringing effect, we have to eliminate the sharp cutoffs in the frequency domain. So this is the reason why ideal filters are rarely used for low pass filtering. So what is the solution? So the solution to eliminate this ringing effect is the Butterworth low pass filter. But before understanding Butterworth low pass filter, let us implement ideal low pass filter in MATLAB. So this program shows ideal low pass filtering. I am reading an input image and converting it to grayscale image if it is a color image. I am plotting in one of the slot out of 2x3, that is 6 portions. I am plotting in the first portion. Next, I am finding out the size of this image and storing in M and N. Why? Because we need to take M by 2 and N by 2 later, right? I am assigning some cutoff frequency. Say here I have assigned 50. So you may have question how to choose this cutoff frequency. So this cutoff frequency depends on the pixels. So if your image is 200x200 pixels, then take the half of that, that is 100, and divided by 2. So now I am taking the Fourier transform of this image by using FFT 2, that is 2-dimensional FFT, and subplotting the Fourier transform of the input image without shift in the other location of subplot. So here I will be only plotting the absolute part of A, that is the real part of A, right? Now I will be shifting the origin of A by using FFT shift and again taking the real part of this and subplot. This will show the Fourier transform of input image after shifting, right? Now I am using a variable A low for storing low pass image. So now for u is equal to 1 to m and for v is equal to 1 to n, where u and v are our coordinates of the image, d of uv is equal to square root of u minus m by 2 whole square plus v minus n by 2 whole square. What we are doing here, I have already explained you, we are doing nothing but we are finding out the Euclidean distance of uv from the center of the image, m by 2 n by 2. So if d of uv is less than or equal to d0 as per the formula of ideal low pass filter, I'll be keeping the pixels as it is, storing in A low, as well as the filter will be 1 if it is less than d0. But if it is more than d0, then the pixels will be rejected, hence it is 0, and also the filter will not be having any value, that is 0, it will become black. So after ending the loops, I'll be plotting my ideal low pass filter FILT, and of course we want to see how it looks on the surface plot also, so that we'll be doing using the surface plot. So we can use mesh for showing the surface plot. Now we have shifted our image initially, so again we'll be reshifting the origin of the filtered image. So after reshifting, what we'll be doing, we'll be taking the inverse Fourier transform to return back to the spatial domain, and I'll be subplotting my filtered image in the last portion of subplot. So let us run this program and see the output. So this is my input image in the grayscale form, and the Fourier transform of this input image is like this. So you can see here that most of the energy is located towards the corners. So we need to shift this origin, and after shifting the origin of the image, this will be the Fourier transform of the shifted image that we'll be obtaining. Now we can use a filter mask. In surface plot, it looks like this. So this is my low pass image that you can see over here. So now you can compare the input image and the low pass image. The image has become blurred. So if noise is present in the image, that noise will be rejected, or sharp transitions will be rejected in the output image. But when you zoom this low pass filtered image, you can see the ringing effects that are present in the image. This ringing effect is due to ideal low pass filtering. You can even use the cameraman image and see the output. You can see the rings are clearly visible. The ringing effects are due to the sharp cutoffs in the ideal filter, and to get rid of this ringing effects, we need to eliminate these sharp cutoffs, and this is exactly what we do in Butterworth low pass filter. So this is a transfer function for Butterworth low pass filter, and it does not have a sharp discontinuity, and hence ringing is only observed for filters of higher orders. Let us understand in detail. The transfer function of the Butterworth low pass filter of order n and cutoff frequency d0 from the origin is defined like this, and it has got a perspective plot like this, where you can see there is no sharp discontinuities. When the filter is displayed on the image, it looks like this. You can see here that there is no sharp transition but a gradual transition, but as the order of the filter goes on increasing from 1 to 2, 3, 4 and 5, a small amount of ringing effect does creep in, because the Butterworth low pass filter tends to be an ideal low pass filter. So as this order will increase, it will become an ideal low pass filter. To get good results, we have to use a order of n which is less than or equal to 5. So this is our original image. This is the result of filtering with Butterworth low pass filter of order 2 with cutoff frequency of radius 5, 15, 30, 80 and 230. So you can compare this with our earlier image, this one. You can see here how large the ringing effects are for 10, 30, 60. And here you can see for 30 and 80, the ringing effects are very, very less. This we will be implementing in MATLAB. So this figure shows the spatial representation of Butterworth low pass filters of order 1, 2, 5 and 20, and corresponding gray level profiles through the center of the filters. All the filters have a cutoff frequency of 5, and you can see that as the order of filter increases from 1 to 2 to 5 to 20, the ringing effect increases. Let us implement this Butterworth low pass filter in MATLAB. So this program shows Butterworth low pass filtering, and the program is similar to our earlier program. Initially we are using the order of 1 for this filter, and we are implementing the values of d of uv and h of uv in the for loop. So let us run and see the output. So now you can see here, the ringing effects are not present. But now let us increase the order of the filter and again see the output. So there is a slight ringing effect that you can observe over here for order 4. Let us increase the order to 20 and see the output. So for the Butterworth filter of order 20, you can clearly see the ringing effects that are present. So that means this Butterworth low pass filter also has a tight profile. So what is the solution? The solution is a Gaussian low pass filter that is given by the transformation function like this. So the important point to note here is that the profile of Gaussian low pass filter is not as tight as that of Butterworth low pass filter, and hence no ringing effect is present at all. Let us understand in detail. So in this formula, d of uv is known to you, and sigma is the standard deviation for a Gaussian function and is a measure of the spread of the Gaussian curve. So if we keep sigma is equal to d0, okay, the equation will become like this. You can see here that the response of the Gaussian low pass filter is similar to the Butterworth low pass filter, but there are no ringing effects at all, even if you go to the higher orders of d0 or cutoff frequency. The reason for studying the Gaussian low pass filter is that it has a very important property in the Fourier domain, which can be used as an analysis tool. And the main advantage of Gaussian low pass filter over a Butterworth low pass filter is that we are assured that there will be no ringing effects no matter what filter order we choose to work with. So now again the same figure for Gaussian low pass filter. This shows the filtering with Gaussian low pass filter with cutoff frequency at 5, 15, 30, 80 and 230. And you can compare this figures with our earlier figures and see that the output is quite good even as compared to the Butterworth low pass filter. For example, you can see here a sample text of poor resolution, and when you zoom this particular characters, you can see that the characters are broken. And if you filter this with a Gaussian low pass filter, the broken characters are joined, as you can see here. So Gaussian low pass filter is most advantageous. Let us implement this Gaussian low pass filter in MATLAB. So this program shows Gaussian low pass filter. The program is similar to the earlier programs. So here the cutoff frequency or standard deviation sigma we have chosen is 50 for Gaussian low pass filtering, and the formulas of d and huv is implemented in the for loop. Let us run and see the output. So you can see here after zooming there are no ringing effects that are observed for the Gaussian low pass filter. So that is all for this video class. In the next video class we will be learning frequency domain sharpening filters. Thank you very much.